So as we head into 2023, the drivers of return in IG will be that mix of growth and inflation, and more specifically, whether we get a recession, and if it does occur, the magnitude and the length of that recession. If the tightening that we've seen so far through 2022 is enough to moderate inflation, to bring down risk-free rates, and also that the recession is relatively modest, you're actually looking at a mix of yield and risk that's relatively attractive. If you think about global IG at 5% for 6 years duration, in an environment where kind of growth slows but doesn't go too negative, that's not a bad setup for the market as we go into 2023. So there is quite an interesting opportunity in global IG from a spread perspective as we move into 2023. Remember, inflation isn't necessarily a risk to investment grade per se. If you have higher inflation, higher costs and higher profits, the value of debt on company balance sheets in real terms actually falls. The concern is that the inflation that we've seen stays high, central banks have to tighten even further, and that causes a deeper recession than is currently priced in, which is probably a very low growth or growth around zero. So certainly the ECB and the Bank of England, you know, won't get to the same peak level of rates as the Federal Reserve. We know that the growth outlook is worse in the Eurozone and the UK, owing in large part to increased and elevated energy prices. We also know that those central banks have other things to deal with. So in the case of the ECB, as ever, it has to consider sovereign spreads to bunds as it goes through its tightening cycle and has to manage those risk premia. And the Bank of England also has to manage a supply side shock in the form of Brexit, which is probably going to dampen growth and maybe keep inflation a little bit elevated. But for all those reasons, we think that, you know, the ECB and the Bank of England will have a lower peak and will probably be earlier in getting to the peak of their hiking. So one sector we like within global IG is utilities. Utilities has the same spread as the wider index most of the time, but it really shows its worth in periods of uncertainty around corporate earnings and growth. So for instance, in 2008 with the financial crisis, 2011 with the Eurozone crisis, 2020 with the COVID pandemic, you saw the utilities sector as a whole trading maybe 50 or 100 basis points through the rest of the market. As a result, at the end of 2022, we think an overweight to utilities can provide the same spread, the same income as the wider market, but will give investors a potential hedge if the economic outlook is worse than the market expects and the market starts questioning the earnings capability of other sectors outside utilities, where in utilities, earnings are regulated, are predictable, and we have very good visibility on the earnings side.